In the mighty name of Jesus, every plan of the devil, strike, nullify, in the name of Jesus, every struggle, put out, in the name of Jesus, paralyze the power, every device. The Bible says, we are not ignorant.
He has escaped.
Only through his spare grass. If he is not chasing something, then something must be chasing him. Open up. You are my brother.
I almost fell for Millicent. She almost raped me. You won't believe it. It was an arrest. Some women are devils.
Just like some men, the devil can infiltrate anybody who is not born again and who is not filled with the power of the Holy Ghost and use him or her for his own purpose. Bro, have this. Have this.
For him?
Disciplinary committee. Jesus. Letter of suspension. For what?
For what crime?
No!
Rape? Cause activities? This must be a setup! This must be a setup! It's a complete setup!
You remember Mr. Billy told me he wanted to see me for an urgent and confidential matter. I believe it's the handiwork of Dr. Lamson.
Bro, there is nothing to worry about. Whoever is behind this will surely be exposed and disgraced. He or she will surely see the finger of God. Our prayer begins now!
God.
Let's start our prayers now.
Arise, God of battle. Arise in your anger. Arise with your mighty power. Arise, Almighty God. To heal me and deliver me. Arise, God of battle. Arise in your anger. Arise with your mighty power. Arise, Almighty God. To heal me and deliver me. Arise, Almighty God. To heal me and deliver me. Arise, Almighty God. To heal me and deliver me.
Where are you going to?
Elder, I am heading to Mount Zion to fulfill what is written about me. In fact, I have a date with destiny tonight. For it is written, but upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions.
Wrong. Wrong. You got it all wrong. I'm sure you don't know what is written about you. The only appointment I know you have is at Mount Zion. And for it is written in my whole letter of appointment that upon Mount Zion there shall be rearrangement of destiny, disappointment, and the house of woodland shall remain in destitution.
Too bad, Elder. Because you are talking to the wrong person. My divine destiny is not determined by what is written about the house of woodland. I am a child of covenant, a citizen of the commonwealth of Israel, a joint heir with the prince of peace, a child of authority, and no one, not even you, can stop me from keeping my date with destiny tonight.
Hey, you lie. You lie. Your fathers did not at any point question my authority. How dare you? How dare you question me? Look, the word reigner is not in your family antecedents. Yes. And now if you know what is good for you, find your way out of this place now and go back to your poor state.
I know what is good for me, and that is to get to Mount Zion to fulfill my divine destiny.
You are going nowhere.
I am going somewhere.
Dear me,
it is gross ignorance that makes the rat challenge the lion to a fight. For it is written that when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the spirit of the Lord shall lift up the standard against him. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Behold, all they that were incensed against thee shall be ashamed, and they shall be confounded. They shall be as nothing, and they that strive with thee shall perish. And they shall surely fight against thee, but they shall not prevail against thee, for I am with thee, saith the Lord, to deliver thee.
Thank you, Lord. I am able to go up and take the coffee.
How long has it been since you talked with the Lord and told him your heart's hidden secrets? How long since you prayed? How long since you stayed on your knees till the light shone through? How long has it been since your mind fell
Child of Zion?
How long since your heart knew no burden? Can you call him your friend?
Put on thy strength and move forward. Because the journey is so far, it is not yet time for you to rest. Remember that to have appointment with destiny tonight, be sober, be vigilant, Because your adversary, the devil, roaring as a lion, looking for whom he will devour, is after you.
And would keep you.
Oh, Baba. Night is too dangerous to keep an appointment.
My son.
Why night?
Night is the best time to know the true worth of man. It is time of challenge and difficulties. Also, time of decision.
Since you knew
it is time for private preparation. If your preparation is poor, your public presentation also will be poor. But if your preparation is perfect, your public presentation also will be perfect. I want to tell you tonight, your decision will determine your destination.
And will keep you alone.
Oh, Baba, how long will the night last?
My dear son, it varies from person to person. It's like a school. Some they spend their normal time, normal year. Some they spend extra year due to failure. Some even drop out. While many are obtaining multiple promotions due to their excellent performance. Your performance tonight will now determine your position.
Ah,
Papa. That's it, my son.
I have been encouraged. My strength has been renewed. I am able to go up and take them.
Since you woke with the dawn and fell, this day is with me. Can you call him your friend? How long has it been since you knew that he cared for?
To go up and take the country, to possess the land from Judah.
Welcome to your family boundary. Your linear limitation is here. Nobody in your lineage has ever gone beyond this limit. I did warn you not to embark on this fruitless journey, but you wouldn't listen. Can you now see that my prophecy has come to pass?
But who are you?
A child that asks questions is interested in the answer. Hi, I'm the custodian of your family heritage. The invisible follower of your lineage, the unquestionable strong man in your father's house. I am the keeper of your family pedigree. I am the arrester of your family glory. I am the librarian of your family history. I am the executor of your family constitution. That's who I am.
Today your time is up, because it is written that whatsoever ye shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. For that reason, I command.
The enemy did it when men slept. Can you now see that you are powerless? there is no power again. You are empty. Do you mind if I show you some things that might interest you? Do you mind? Okay, I take your silence for yes. That is the altar housing your family glory.
No. My family glory in a cage? No. But I'm a child of destiny, custodian. I'm not supposed to be a candidate of distress. I am born to reign. Why this reproach? Why this reproach, custodian?
Did I hear you say reign? The word reign is not in your family antecedents. No reigner has ever emerged from your family. And so be it.
Custodian, but why? Why?
It's because it's not part of your family heritage. It's a question of foundation. Haven't you read it? That if the foundation be destroyed, what shall the righteous do? In my own opinion, the righteous should accept their fate, wander and die in the wilderness of life.
If the foundation be destroyed, if the foundation be destroyed,
what shall the righteous do?
The righteous will pray. The righteous should pray an effectual fervent prayer. Bro, we are going to pray like this. Blood of Jesus!
Blood of Jesus!
Prepare my foundation!
In the wilderness of life, instead for you to move forward, you are moving back.
Don't let me die like this, Baba.
my mother, my family, and my generation are all waiting for my manifestation. I must not fail them, Baba. I must not end up a failure. Help me. Help me.
Failure is never your portion at all. Because the message of the Lord is upon you, your request is granted.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. My authority has been restored. My weapon of war, stolen by the enemy, has been recovered. Thank you.
This frustrated failure has refused to give up. He wants to break through my barricade to the land of fulfillment. How do I dance to this rhythm? Oh, what do I do?
Psalms chapter 16 verse 5 says, the Lord is the portion of my inheritance and of my cup.
It is also written in section 1, article 3b of your family constitution that no reigner shall emerge in your lineage.
Deuteronomy chapter 9 verse 3. Understand therefore this day that the Lord thy God is he which goeth before thee. As a consuming fire, he shall destroy them and shall bring them down before thy face. So shalt thou drive them out and destroy them quickly, as the Lord has said unto thee.
Article 4 of your family constitution also says that he that tries to break through in your family will break down. Therefore, I command you to break down now.
I shall not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at my side, and 10,000 at my right hand, but it shall not come near me. Only with my eyes shall I behold and see the reward of the wicked.
Abomination. This one has finally made it to his land of fulfillment. What a loss. What a great loss. No. No. I will not let go of him. Yes. Let me go and re-examine his family constitution so as to know the right section to invoke against him in order to bring him down from the top of the ladder of success. Yes. Yes. I remain the legal custodian of his family heritage as long as my letter of appointment is still with me. Yes. Let me go.
You are welcome to Mount Zion. I'm the angel of fulfillment. I'm at your service anytime.
Angel of fulfillment?
Yeah, the prince of the Most High.
Yeah. Quickly get me my academic fulfillment. Someone out there is gambling with it.
The custodian of your family heritage has just come last week to claim it on your behalf.
Why? And what does he want to do with it?
As for why, he has a legal right to do so. and as for what he wants to do with it, anything he likes.
Abba! Angel of fulfillment. You shouldn't have given it to him, knowing fully that it belongs to a prince.
Oh, prince. What you don't understand is that we respect our legal rights here.
Okay. What is the way out now? The way forward?
It is not my ministry to teach you that. I'm sure your teacher must have taught you that.
Don't even go too far. I know what to do. For it is written that thou shalt decree a thing, and then it shall be established unto you, and the light shall shine upon thy ways. For that reason, I decree that every ancestral legal right of darkness that has caged my life, your time is up. Catch fire!
My legal right is destroyed. My letter of appointment. Family constitution of Woodland.
You strong man of my father's house, gambling with my fulfillment, gambling with my academic success, gambling with my destiny, gambling with my glory. What do you think you are doing? You are a liar. Hey, catch fire! You satanic altar, how see my glory, how see my success, how see my fulfillment, how see my joy. Masquerida Casantareka, hey, the Lord is against you. Hear ye the word of authority. Mascoropos Kentala, your time is up. Release them and catch fire.
Your glory can no longer be hidden. The world can now hear your voice. You are ready to reign in life. Meanwhile, here is the academic fulfillment.
Hallelujah. Angel of fulfillment.
At your service.
I need my financial fulfillment. Enough of poverty in my lineage.
Praise the Lord. I am victorious. I have won the battle.
Prince, here is your financial fulfillment. Go and prosper.
Thank you, angel of fulfillment.
That is the best of my mind. Once I believe that we got a things that possible. He has done it. He has done it.
Hallelujah.
He has done it. He has done it.
Mommy, this pair of shoes that Dad forced on me is giving me a serious pain. It's pinching me.
Son, I want you not to put it on in the first place. Can't you see it's no longer your size? You have outgrown the limitations.
But Mom, it was my size then.
That was then. You have to remove it.
It's painful.
You have to remove it.
Thank you, Mommy. Yeah! At last I'm free! Thank you, Lord.
Today, I set ablaze every evil limitation in your father's house, every demotion, every setback.
No more limitation for my son. No more setback. No more demotion. I set ablaze every evil shoe of your father's house.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for delivering my son from ancestral afflictions. Oh, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I bless you.
Letter of expulsion. I'm being expelled for the crime I did not commit. God, this is unfair. This is unfair. What will I tell my mother?
I don't know, Matt.
Oh, my son.
I won't buy a kuli kuli.
Okay.
You get a pack of biscuit?
Yes.
Okay. Kuli kuli 35 naira.
Okay.
Pack of biscuit one.
Yeah.
Okay. Just give me one, Just give me one. Yeah. This is your kuli kuli day, okay?
Thank you. No, no. Oh, my daughter.
What am I?
You're fine, sir. Okay, thank you.
I'm set.
Okay.
So what do I do for you this month?
Well,
I'm really going to miss you, no more.
But look, I want you to understand what this admission means to the entire family. Know that you are going there to keep a date with destiny. Remain focused and flee youthful lust and immorality. Because they destroy like wildfire.
Mom, I promise I won't disappoint you, God helping me. I won't fail the Lord who has fearfully fashioned me to fulfill his divine purpose of liberating my entire lineage from the shackles of linear limitation. Mom, I know that posterity will not forgive me if I fail to fulfill my purpose of existence. So relax. Once you have spoken, twice I have heard it, that I have a date with destiny.
I'm glad, my son, that you have not forgotten the purpose of your existence. I cannot have my peace. Thank you, Lord, for ordaining my son to be the one that will lift the long-standing satanic embargo over the lineage of Woodland. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, I know you will not allow me to be put to shame. Hard to feel, Lord. Do I lift up my soul? Hard to feel, Lord. Do I lift up my soul? Oh, my God. Trust in me. Let me not be ashamed. Let not my enemies triumph over me. every opportunity to rewrite my history. What will I tell my descendants if I fail?
Bro, you can't fail. You can't fail because of Jesus. The Lord is still on the throne. There would always be a light at the end of the tunnel. The enemy has been exposed and be disgraced. The VC wants to see you. This letter is invalid.
Sir, this young man here has a startling confession to make. He used to be a member of the dreaded Jupiter fraternity, but he recently renounced his membership of the cult, and he deemed it fit to make this confession, sir.
I see. Young man, I'm all ears. Sir, in the first place, there was no rape whatsoever on that day, sir. It was all planned out just to implicate Pascal Woodland, who happens to be the enemy of Dr. Adamson, the godfather and promoter of the fraternity. Young man, I hope this is not blackmail. No, sir. Mr. Billy, I hope this is not your handiwork to save the career of one of your favorite students. You know you don't have to rub it out of paper. I hope you are very sure of that.
God forbid, sir. I can't do such a thing against my colleague. I have nothing to do with it, sir.
Can you defend this allegation before the disciplinary committee and the Senate?
Yes, sir. With facts and figures, sir. I still have my own copy of the script he wrote, signed and delivered to us on this operation, sir. I am not doing this out of sympathy for Pascal, sir. But it's a question of conscience. I'd rather bear the consequence of my action than watch an innocent man suffer for the crime he didn't commit, sir.
If that be the case, the authority will investigate thoroughly this case and we'll review the expulsion of that young lad. What is his name?
Pascal.
And if this grave allegation is proven to be true, Adamson will face the consequence and will serve as a deterrent to other lecturers who are involved in such wicked acts. Am I clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Pascal. Finally, it has been proven beyond every cloud of doubt that you are innocent. And the mastermind of this plot against your career has been unmasked. Your case has made me to believe this popular saying that destiny cannot be changed.
Sir?
Yes?
Dr. Adamson is here to see you, sir. Should I let him in?
I don't want to set my eyes on him. I don't want to see that devil incarnate. Tell him!
You just have to listen
to me. Excuse me, sir.
You just have to listen to me, sir. Please, sir.
Adamson, you have nothing to explain.
Excuse me, sir.
Please, sir.
The decision has been taken and it is final. I'm sorry, this institution does not need demons like you. So go and burn in hell.
Please, sir. You just have to save my career. Do not allow my 20 years of service become a wasted effort. Please, sir, consider my family and future.
Shut that your mouth up. The egg eater does not think of the pain it has caused the hen. You should have considered all that before allowing your personal and primordial interest to push you that far.
Adam's sin, you should have considered the implication of your action before attempting to frustrate the flourishing career of this young man.
You don't realize that this is the best engineering student this institution has ever produced on record. Oh, are you not aware of that?
Please, sir, forgive me, sir. It will not repeat itself.
You are right. You won't even have the opportunity of imagining it, let alone doing it. Don't you realize that before Providence, you would have succeeded in wasting one of the best brains this institution would have produced? In my 35 and the 4 walls of the higher institution, I have never seen a promising young lad that has maintained a very high CGPA like this young lad. He has just one semester to graduate with probably a first-class degree. Adamson, in fact, you should be thanking your star that I did not hand you over to the police for prosecution.
Please, sir, forgive me, sir. It was the devil that pushed me.
Maybe you don't know that you committed a criminal offense, not only against this institution, but against this nation as a whole. Now, Adamson, leave my office before I call the police. Adamson, leave my office.
Please, Pascal, forgive me. Help me beg the DC to forgive me. Please.
Hey, young man. You are returning to this school after your service to contribute your own quota in making this institution one of the best in this country and probably this continent in the area of science and technology.
So tell all those blue chip companies that will run after you after your service to employ you that you are not available. Am I clear?
Sir, it will be a great honor to serve this reputable institution, sir. It will be a dream come true, sir.
Pascal, I am proud of you.
Thank you, sir.
This institution is proud of you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Adamson, get out of my office before I call the police. Get out.
Please don't forgive me, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
It is grace. A disgrace to this institution.
Nonsense.